Hello. Today I'm going to show you how to disassemble a Yamaha DT50LC electric part. We begin by first removing the plastic cover on the left side. There are 5 screws. You will need an Allen key, and you need to take note of where they go, since there are 2 screw sizes, one of which longer than the other. This is the magnetic flywheel. To remove it, we need a number 19 socket wrench. The knob 1 screw is normal to the left, but you will need to stop the engine from rotating, or it won't come out. The easiest way to do that is to remove the spark plug. Use a specialized part or jig such as this one, that will lock the piston and prevent the engine from rotating. As you can see, the flywheel is now locked, and we can proceed to unscrew the nut. There should be very little resistance, and you can unscrew it easily by hand, or else you may have to use a pneumatic or impact wrench, but be aware that you may damage the piston if you apply too much force. Under the nut, there should be a couple of washers. Next, we use a flywheel extractor. Beware that it screws counterclockwise, so pay close attention and don't force it in. After you tighten the extractor, just use a normal wrench to turn the screw clockwise. You should feel the flywheel coming out slowly. Gently rock it by hand and remove it. Take note of the small half-moon part that secures the flywheel to the crankshaft. Don't lose it. I had already replaced the signal pickup in the main power coil. The old ones were in bad shape and weren't reliable. The white and red cable is the pickup signal cable. The black and red cable is the power cable. Both will go into the CDI, together with the ground. This is an aftermarket unlimited CDI. It takes 3 inputs. Pickup. Power. Ground and outputs the power to the ignition coil on the orange wire. I will use a couple of zip ties to secure the CDI to the bike frame, but you can bolt it on. To reassemble it, just take note on the flywheel groove, and align it with the little half-moon part on the crankshaft. Gently push it in, and, once it's secure, place the washers in the nut. With the jig still on the spark plug socket, rotate the flywheel and tighten the nut, but don't overdo it. All that is left is to replace the cover, and it's ready to roll. Enjoy your rides. Don't forget to like and subscribe.